Good day. This will be the continuation of my first discussion related to e-learning. Now, the next topic will focus on e-learning components. E-learning approaches can combine different types of e-learning components, as I mentioned or with my previous video, including e-learning content, e-tutoring, e-coaching, e-mentoring, collaborative learning, and virtual classroom. So let's have a quick look at these components. So e-learning content so include simple learning resources, interactive lessons, electronic simulation, and job aids. The simple learning resources are non-interactive resources such as documents, PowerPoint presentations, videos, or audio files. These materials are non-interactive in the sense that learners can only read or watch content without performing any other actions. These resources can be quickly developed, and when they match defined learning objectives and are designed in a structured way, they can be a valuable learning resource even though they don't provide any interactivity. When it comes to interactive lesson, or interactive e-lesson, the most common approach for self-paced e-learning is web-based training consisting a set of interactive e-lesson. An e-lesson is a linear sequence of screens which can include text, graphics, animation, audio, video, and interactivity in the form of questions and feedback. E-lessons can also include recommended reading and links to online resources as well as additional information on specific topics. Electronic simulation. Simulation are highly interactive forms of e-learning. The term simulation basically means creating a learning environment that simulates the real world, allowing the learner to learn by doing, and simulation are a specific form of web-based training that immerse the learner in a real-world situation and respond in a dynamic way to his or her behavior. So, I mentioned earlier job aids. Now, job aids provide just-in-time knowledge. They can take several forms and be delivered on different platforms. Example, computer, printed document, mobile phone. They usually provide immediate answers to a specific question, thus helping user accomplish job tasks. Technical glossaries and checklists are a few examples of simple job aids, but sophisticated expert system can also be developed to assist workers in complex decision making. E-tutoring, e-coaching, and e-mentoring. Services which provide human and social dimension can be offered to learners to support them through the learning experience. The e-tutoring or e-coaching or e-mentoring provide individual support and feedback to learners through online tools and facilitation techniques. Collaborative learning are activities range from discussion and knowledge sharing to working together on a common project. Social software such as chats, discussion forums, and blogs are used for online collaboration among learners. The online discussion, we have synchronous and asynchronous online discussion. Actually, these two are designed to facilitate communication and knowledge sharing among learners. Learners can comment and exchange ideas about course activities or contribute to group learning by sharing their knowledge. For collaboration, collaborative project work implies collaboration among learners to perform a task. A collaborative activities can include project work and scenario-based assignments. Virtual classroom. A virtual classroom is the instructional method most similar to traditional classroom training, as it is led completely by an instructor. A virtual classroom is an e-learning event where an instructor teaches remotely and in real time to a group of learners using a combination of materials, either PowerPoint, slides, audio or video materials. It is also called synchronous learning. This method requires the least amount of effort to convert materials, but instructors still have to prepare them. Appropriately, technology must be in place for both the learners and providers. For example, software for the virtual classroom and good connectivity. For synchronous and asynchronous e-learning activities can be synchronous or asynchronous. Synchronous events take place in a real time, and synchronous communication between two people requires them to both be present at a given time. Example of synchronous activities are chat conversation and audio or video conferencing. For asynchronous events are time independent. A self-paced course is an example of asynchronous e-learning because online learning takes place at any time. Email or discussion forums are example of asynchronous communication tools. So, again, for synchronous, we could be able to use chat and IM, video and audio conferencing, live webcasting, application sharing, whiteboard, and pooling. For asynchronous, email, discussion forum, wiki, blog, webcasting, and so on. The flexibility of internet technology creates gray areas around the concept of synchronous and asynchronous. So, for example, video and audio session can be recorded and made available for learners who cannot attend a live event. And for quality of e-learning, no? The quality of e-learning course is enhanced by a learner-centered content. E-learning curricula should be relevant and specific to learners' needs, rules, and responsibility in professional life. Skills, knowledge, and information should be provided to this end. Granularity. E-learning content should be segmented to facilitate assimilation of new knowledge and to allow flexible scheduling of time for learning. Engaging content, instructional methods and techniques should be used creatively to develop an engaging and motivating learning experience. Interactivity, a frequent learner interaction is needed to sustain attention and promote learning. And personalization, a self-paced courses should be customizable to reflect learners' interests and needs. In instructor lead courses, tutors and facilitators should be able to follow the learner's progress and performance individually. And that's it. Thank you.